Tôi mong cùng sống các thoại mong cùng xâm đạch Brahma sang kỳ rệt tăng phí kỳ nạ chế kỳ tì kỳ rập sức kà rạ nọc quân phố hôn phốt. Sống các thoại mong cùng xâm đạch bà sang dụ, xâm đạch bà sang dụ rô, xâm đạch bà rệt chế kỳ nạ Brahma trái sang bà thê ràn thê rạ kỳ rập răng tì kỳ rập sức kà rạ. Sống dùm ràn phố xâm đạch trông ai đông lục chùm tiêu ở lục lục sầy, nhiệt nhôm xa thụ sập rọc bà sầy tiếng ọ đào sức đầy xa lành rập án khăn ông bà thù. My deepest homage to the Triple Gem. Would like to pay my deep respect to Their Holinesses. My respect to most venerable monks. Dear lay devotees, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the program Studying Buddhism and Philosophy in English. This is a program from Mongkol One Temple, Phnom Penh, Cambodia. Today, we'd like to bring you to another new topic, that is threefold training and Buddhist life. Thay ni khyom kanatma nung nai nuam phe sa ampi vathena bot thmey mu tiet ke trai sikha nung chivit chia put sasanak. Today, a little bit late because I had program
today
outside of Phnom Penh.
A little bit late because I had
I went to a funeral of one venerable monks who passed away a few days ago. He's the Sangha governor or Sangha leader of Ong Snu district, Kondal province. Just returned to my temple, and also before this I had to inspect the work of the craftsmen and the masons who are doing the repairing jobs of my main Buddha hall. So I'm a little bit late, but this time tends to have many people to join this program. When I start at 7 o'clock in the evening, it seems there are less people. So is it good to have a program at 8? And yeah, a program can last approximately 1 hour or less, depending on the day and on the topic. Sometimes I'm tired, so I make it short. Now, let's come to the topic. Threefold training and Buddhist life. It is important to know the threefold training or Trisika or Tisika. Pali is Tisika. We say like we spell like this. Or this Pali. But it is a little bit difficult to twist the tongue, Tisika. So we use the Sanskrit Trisika. So we use the Sanskrit form of this term Trisika. In fact, if all in Sanskrit, it should be Trisiksa. Yeah, Trisiksa. But we use sort of a combination. One part is Sanskrit, one part is Pali. So Trisika. It's depending on the convenience of our tongue. So that's how we have to follow the which is the common form. So we don't use much the Tisika, but we use Trisika. So Tri is Sanskrit, Sika is Pali. If all in Sanskrit, it should be Trisiksa. Trisiksa. Now let's look at this. English, we say threefold because it's consisting of three. And then training. You know, training, that's giving instruction, teaching, guiding. So that's threefold training. Sikha or Siksha in Sanskrit means studying. Yeah, it means studying. Literally means studying. But the aim is more than just studying, but it's kind of more rigorous studying. So it's become training. Training is more rigorous than studying. So this one is more appropriate than studying, training. So the important, what is threefold training in Buddhism? So now you know the meaning of threefold training or Trisika. Now for lay people, mostly for lay people, this is the common form for threefold training or Trisika for lay people. I may say that lay person, yeah, it can be classified as such.
Nó dục sai nó phải tiền nó mới đã xả nó lên. đã chết rồi, sai về nhé.
Yes, Venerable Sun Sei Hong.
Yeah, can say Upasaka, Upasika.
Upasa, Upasika.
This for lay people. So, for lay people, it consists of basic. We say basic.
Yeah.
Basic training. Yeah, basic training.
Cứ ca ọp rúm rư ca sạc xa mù lửa thán. Chia mù lửa thán rư thạ đầm bông đầm bông. It consists of dana, charity or tiền, cái thừa tiền. Number two, sila, morality or self. Then number three, bhavana or pyavaniya, mental development. Mental development. Bhavana here is more than meditation, but it's more mental development. Because in the training, it has to be more action oriented. You see, action oriented. But meditation quite not so active and not so rigorous. So here mental training covers this part of the practices. See, it's more than just meditation. It's mental development. Bhavana. We may say also development for the social terms or for the social condition. So bhavana,
this with a diametrical mark here.
Now chia bị sạc máy phiền bhavana in the Romanized Pali. Cứ dương ai như vậy tha chia mental development, mình trầm tai chia meditation thom na tế pro meditation vi ở sư sắc cam vi ở sư đầm rơi ao miền sắc cam một hiệp khang khai vận tai chia tu tới cứ kia tha nơi không đầm nặng cao này training nâng nơi cả bậc đồng bậc đa rứa sĩ khá ní cứ tiềm tia ao miến sự cả một hiệp nâng ca vật hạt tràn cứ vật hạt phở chật ní cứ chân cái prao phía mental development. Now back, now this are very necessary
very necessary
for lay people, as a Buddhist, you cannot avoid doing this or practicing this. This is important. So, as you know, charity or giving donation is very important for
your life, for especially lay life, as lay people, you need to practice this. See, why charity or giving donation is so important for a lay Buddhist life? Because as you give, you know, it's not only just action then handing over, but you have a soft heart, compassionate heart. Out of compassion, you give something. And the best way of giving in Buddhism is giving without expectation. You don't expect things in return. Or when you help others, don't just expect others to help you back. It's just act of pure act of help or giving. That's the best way of giving in Buddhism, according to the teaching of the Buddha. So charity or giving donation is very important, that you have soft heart and compassion. You know, as you give, you feel so compassionate for the recipients. Hãy đây bàn tay cát vừa tiến cứ chia rừng sầm khăn. Bồ tha cát vừa tiến cứ thua ao nhận thua nào ấy nó cứ miên chất cả rồi na là miên chất sầm đau anh nhất là số đo nhận đel rong tóc nhận đel chụp cá lục bà chụp cá khoa khát hay chất tu tuân chất năng miên cả anh nhất là số mình tên nhớ không cứ dừng ao ấy tới cứ chưa mui năng tập chất cả rồi ná tập chất tu tuân tập chất ăn nứt ở sâu khẳng. So that giving make your heart soft and compassionate, and it's very conducive to practicing the Buddhist principles. And other teachings of the Buddha. So that's why the Buddha always appreciate the act of giving, charity. And in fact, in most of the, you know, the items, the Buddha ranked charity or dana first, as first, number one. Yeah, correct. It's you trying to listen and to eliminate stinginess. Thank you. That's it. And before that, of course, one act of giving will not eliminate stinginess. Còn tại phương tiện mà đón vì ọt ai bấm bắt nơi xích đây cầm nánh nhé. Còn tại tầm bốn, cứ tầm nạc ca tầm bốn, cứ phương ở chất rồi bao dương tu tuôn cả rô na miên xích đây ăn đất ở sầu. This is important. So for lay people, this is very important that you start by having your soft heart, compassion towards other people, other beings, you know? So that it's very convenient to practice other principles or teachings of the Buddha. Now, sila, morality, is connect, and it's more important in terms of gravity. You know, this is first and this is the second, but it's more important as you become mature in your life and you can practice this, you know, because charity or generosity can be done by anyone, even non-Buddhist. The butchers, the killers can also do charity, can also perform generosity. So this is very normal, very common, because all beings subsist on food, all beings live because of food. So anybody can perform this charity. But sila is more important and it comes directly to the heart of the of Buddhist practices. As we all stress sila, morality, that we Buddhist lay people or monks need to follow precepts and other relevant principles in Buddhism. So sila comes next, but more important, and this you know, it makes you sure, make you guiltless. When you practice these precepts and you have morality, then you have the heart which is pure, which is non-blemish, which is so clean. So that's very conducive to other practices, especially to mental training or mental development. Without this, mental development is a little bit, no, it's very hard, and sometimes it's impossible for you to progress in mental training. So sila conducive to mental development. So now come to this point, bhavana. We pronounce bhavana, not because it has to be with age, and you cannot write with P here. Some people like this, it's wrong. But it has to be B, because B here, Bha, yeah. So B here, it has to be H, Bha. Bhavana, in the social sense, is development. So who says Buddhism is far away from development? In fact, Buddhism itself is development. Without development, there's no Buddhism. You come to Buddhism is for development, not for other things. Development in your character, in your speech, in your bodily action, especially in your
mind. That's development. Without development, nothing in Buddhism. And you come to Buddhism for nothing. That's all. Buddhism, especially this concept, bhavana, is development. So when you come to Buddhism, you follow Buddhist teaching, is for development. That's the only point for development. I speak in Khmer a little bit. Pioneer, cứ miền Tây tha ca chầm rán, cứ áp hiệp vọt. Nhưng ai tha áp hiệp vọt, cứ áp hiệp vọt. Project, đó là cái này áp hiệp vọt project. Áp hiệp vọt. Nè đại tha, Phật Phật Sa Sna cứ tùy bị ca áp hiệp vọt. Cứ vô khẩu hài. Nhưng bà đi bắt tam thua rồi bỏ bộ cứ đam bây áp hi vọt. Áp hi vọt tiếng ả tạ chá rắc rồi bỏ dương, tiếng sông đầy, tiếng sạc mập hiệp phơi cài. Chia phí xét cứ áp hi vọt phơi chật. Để trở tại thua chia bỏ chậm. Chẳng cứ bộ Phật Sa Sna cứ áp hi vọt nặng ai. Bà ọt áp hi vọt thế, ọt áp hi vọt khluôn thế. Cứ mình chứ mô tha bà đi bắt tam bộ Phật Sa Sna tam phía phình bà đá ở bộ Phật thế. Now, so it's very clear that bhavana is development. You come to Buddhism, you follow the Buddha's teaching, is for development. Development in your character, we call character development or character molding. Yeah. I erase this. Bhavana development cứ development character speech bodily action bodily this development. Yeah. You may also say character building. This what the popular words at the present time. Character building. So development in your character, development in your speech, development in your bodily actions. And importantly, correct development in your mind, mental development. Yeah, mental development. So, in Buddhism, when you come to Buddhism, you practice the Buddha's teaching for development. Without this, it's nothing.
So you come to Buddhism for nothing. So you need to develop. So Buddhism is development. I hope you get the point. Buddhism is for development. For example, as a person, now for lay person, before you come to practice Buddhism, you were in a shape, I would not say bad, but quite nasty, quite bad, no, in your character, your speech, your bodily action, or even your thinking. So once you come to practice Buddhism and you get into this training, you have to give up your bad habits, your bad speech, bad bodily action, bad character. No. That's development, and you develop instead of just giving up the bad speech, bad bodily action, bad habits, bad characters, and bad mental process. You instead develop good speech, good bodily actions, good habits, good character, and good mental development. That's development in Buddhism. So the word here, the word bhavana, is very important. As it means Buddhism is development. When you come to practice Buddhist teaching, you have to develop yourself. So the modern term, they say transformation. Self-transformation. Self-transformation. So when you practice the Buddha's teaching, it means you transform yourself. Now this concept, self-transformation, is very popular in the modern time, but in fact the Buddha taught it over 2600 years ago. But we did not do it properly, and sometimes we misunderstand this point. So this self-transformation or self-development is very important in your life. If you cannot have self-development or self-transformation, you will be condemned to the same person or even worse, bad person, if you cannot transform yourself or develop yourself. So people who are success are the people who can transform themselves. So bhavana here, we may also use the modern term, it's self-transformation or self-development. self transformation. So I say a person who has the ability, sorry, to self-transform So in our life, any person who has the ability to self-transform or self-develop tends to get success, tend to be successful in their life. So if you can transform yourself, you can be a successful person in all sphere, in all domains, whether in your workplace or as a student or in business, you need to do self-transformation. Then you will be a successful person. Because when you transform yourself, it means you catch up with new things, with new ways, with the new method, then you can go on and become a successful person. That's if you cannot transform yourself, you cannot develop yourself, you will be the same or you will get worse, because as the law of nature, there cannot be the same things as the time pass by. So either you go up or you go down. If you don't develop yourself, you become deteriorated or you become worse. Now, bhavana is the most important concept in Buddhism and along with Samadhi. In fact, all the teachings of the Buddha can be summed up in this concept, bhavana. Because that bhavana will develop yourself, develop your mind, and your mind progresses until you reach the stage of the Arahanthood or even the Buddhahood. Yeah. That's because of this concept, Bhavana or Samadhi. So this is very important. You need to do. Now, the question is, can we do it only once at a time? For example, in some part of your life, you do charity, and then some part of your life, you do modality. Some part of your life, you do bhavana or mental development. No. This is not meant to be so. You have to perform it all at once, all at the same time. I'll speak in Khmer a little bit, Cambodian language. Sam nu su tha ta bokol ai thveu ai padibat ka thveu tien knong muoy damnak ka nei chivit teu hai ma damnak ka tiet raksa sel hai ma damnak ka tiet at raksa sel he keu chamran samathi phavaniya ta ai thveu chang te neu knong trai sikha ni Phật mình bằng riêng bài năng tế cứ chẳng ai dưỡng bà đi bắt phòng khía không phê tại mùi tôi bây tha phê khá dưỡng chập đam đời cả phở tiến có phân tái dưỡng mình trở phết rỡ xa sở hay có mình trở phết áp hi vót phơi chật cứ chấm rán xa mạ thị phía vào nì mình đây tha khăn ông trai sĩ khá ní cứ trâu tay ăn vật prom khnìa ăn vật prom khnìa dương ai thừa tiền tích vấn đề rửa xa sờ sầm khẩn hay chấm ran samadhi phía bên nia có sầm khẩn nè nằm với ban được bảy nhà bờ ăn miên chấm ran samadhi phía bên nia ăn miên ban được bảy nhà thế Now, this bhavana will lead to knowledge and wisdom. Panya or prajna. So if you don't do mental development, you cannot get this knowledge or wisdom. Because as you know, prajna, a reason by three ways. Sutta Majapanya by listening, Chinta Majapanya by thinking, by consideration or reflection, and then Pyavaniya Majapanya or Bhavana Majapanya by mental development or mental training, that you can get knowledge and wisdom. No? So these three ways will get, you will get wisdom. So here it's, this is important. Bhavana Pyavaniya will bring you knowledge and wisdom. It's very clear here. By listening, also it's, you listen to somebody teaching, somebody speaking, explaining, that can get wisdom, but can get knowledge, but not really the real wisdom of things as they are. But by reflection also you can get knowledge, but not the real wisdom. But by this mental training, by mental concentration, mental concentration, you will get wisdom. So this bhavana is very important. Very, in the Buddha's teaching, if you don't practice, you miss some part of the Buddha's teaching. Don't say that, oh, you get the wisdom or panya without doing meditation or this mental concentration. That's not the case. Even you practice this morality and you have the sila or cell, you adhere to the disciplinary rules. But if you don't practice concentration, mental concentration, you won't get the wisdom, especially the real wisdom of things as they are. Yathabhuta jnana dasana. Yathabhuta jnana dasana. So bhavana is an important part of the Buddha's teaching or of Buddhism, that if you want to get knowledge, wisdom, that you need to practice mental concentration or wisdom or this mental training. Now, this is for lay person, upasaka, upasika, or lay people, puttabhasatyagraha. This threefold training is conducive to being a good Buddhist, to leading a good Buddhist life. If you practice this, it's, you have a good Buddhist life. Not only good Buddhist life, but a good life as a whole. Because you are generous, compassionate, and you have morality, you are virtuous person, then you have this mental development, mental concentration, then you are complete. As a person, you're very noble already. So having this in your life, you are leading a good Buddhist life already. Another point I want to bring to your attention also. Now, we Buddhists
When we say Buddhist, Bodhika,
what it means that being Buddhist, it means you have to have wisdom. So here, wisdom, panya, so
just no, this is from the Pali term Bodhika or Buddhika or of the Buddha. According to the English, it means that you are part of the enlightenment. Buddhist is part of enlightenment because Buddha is enlightened person. So when we are Buddhist, we are part of the enlightened person or part of enlightenment. It means we have to have wisdom. So Buddhists need to have knowledge, need to have wisdom, you know. Otherwise, it does not fit with this concept, with this term.
Trong câu này, trong này dạy tha chia Phật sa sơn ức, chia Phật thì Phật sa Phật sa sơn ức cứ tham biết biết bởi lấy cái Phật thì cả, nè Buddhika, Buddhika, Buddhika miền này tha nợ miền prạ nhà. Chẳng chia Phật thì cả, chia Phật sa sơn ức cứ tham miền prạ nhà, nè Phật tha Phật thì cả mau biết Phật thệ năng nệ cả và cháy là tới chia bộ cuốn tới chia một nút cứ nợ miên tại nhà rồi nợ miên chấm nay đây cá trả đằng chẳng không niệm chia Phật thì cả chia Phật sa sơn ức cứ dương tới tai miên tại nhà chia sẽ cứ áp vượt sao tập hiệp phơi chết sao tập hiệp chấm nay đằng sao tập hiệp tại nhà nắng ao miên tôi lung tôi lìa chưa chưa hay ao căn tay phù lãng nè ban sạ xóm chia Phật sa sơn ức Phật thì cả pro dương chia phần này mũi nấy ca tra đắng chia phần này mũi nấy bài nhà nhiên nè. So I think today is enough. It's almost 1 hour. The day after tomorrow, I will continue this with the another part, that is the part for the monastic life, sila, samadhi, and panya, morality, concentration, and wisdom. That's also the threefold training in Buddhism. So we'll discuss the day after tomorrow. For today, I think that is enough. Thank you for watching. Wishing you all the best and success in your life. Thank you.